Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video we are going to look at some maths problems that have been answered incorrectly by a student. Your job is to identify the mistakes in the student's calculations. Detecting and correcting mistakes can be a powerful opportunity for enhancing your learning. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. Let's look at question 1. The student has been given an equation to solve. 2x plus 5 equals 15. The student has answered this question incorrectly. Have a look at the student's calculations to see if you can spot where they have gone wrong. Pause the video if you need to. To help you spot the mistake, here is the correct answer, which is x equals 5. Hopefully you have spotted where the student made an incorrect calculation. Here, instead of dividing by 2, to find the value of x, they multiplied by 2. Leading to an incorrect solution. Up until that point, they had correctly rearranged and simplified the equation. Question 2. The student has been given a rectangle with measurements and asked to find the perimeter. See if you can spot the mistake in the student's workings out. Here is the correct answer for your reference. Here, the student has incorrectly used the formula for finding the area, multiplying the length by the width, instead of adding up the distance around the edge of the shape, to find the perimeter. Question 3. The student has been asked to find 3 quarters of 60. Have a look at their answer and calculations to see if you can spot where the student made an error. To help you identify this, the correct answer to the question is 45. Here, we can see the student made an error in their calculation of 60 divided by 4, which equals 15. However, the student noted down 12 for their answer, resulting in the subsequent calculations being incorrect, despite the fact the method they used would have worked. Question 4 is another equation to solve, 2y plus 8 equals 14 minus y. See if you can spot the error in the student's calculations. The student has incorrectly calculated y to equal 6, however the correct answer is y equals 2. Here, the mistake was made when the student took y away from both sides. Should they have instead correctly added y to both sides of the equation to cancel out the minus y, they would have ended up with 6 equals 3 lots of y, instead of 1 y. They would have needed an extra step to find out what y on its own equals. Question 5. If a car travels at 60 miles per hour, how long will it take to travel 90 miles? Take a look at the student's answer to identify the mistake. The correct answer to this question is that it would take 1.5 hours, or 90 minutes, for the car to travel 90 miles. Here the student hasn't noted down any of their workings out, making it difficult to see exactly where they went wrong. It seems they had correctly noted down that in 1 hour the car would travel 60 miles, and then worked out it would take an additional 30 minutes to travel the 90 miles. However, it looks as though they forgot to add up these two timings. Finally, question 6 asks the student to find the missing angle labeled X. See if you can spot where the student went wrong. For reference, the correct answer is 28 degrees. We can see here that the student used the external angle of 53 degrees in their calculation, using the formula for finding the angles in a triangle. As this is an external angle, they should have first found the internal angle by using the angles on a straight line rule. They should then have used this internal angle they had calculated, which is 127 degrees, in their calculation of angles in a triangle. That's all for today. Hopefully, identifying the mistakes in this student's work has helped you to see some common errors made in maths, and highlighted the importance of checking your work. as we are all human and are prone to making careless mistakes, no matter how deep our knowledge of a subject. Thanks for watching Minity Maths.